now what happened is, now I have a disk, I'm drawing the disk in a different shape now. The round disk became this shape, okay? So this disk is a regular disk. Then I converted this to physical disk, sorry, physical volume, okay? When I convert to physical volume, it creates some areas here. That areas are called PE. What is PE?
PE.
Apart from your PVRA now. And a lost, and another area here, right? So what is PE? PE is a small area. This is PE. All these are PE. What is PE? Small areas. By default, it is 4 megabytes. 4 megabytes. But it can be 1 megabyte to 255 megabytes or 6. That is the size it can occupy. But when you are creating, you are tell what is the size we want, right? When you are creating. We say PV create minus physical extent, PE minus PE, and we have to put the thing, right? The number on burnout, right? We can check. We will come to that when you do the man page of PV create, right? So physical extent by default is what is the size?
4
megabytes each. So this also have 4 megabytes each, physical extents.
By default they are 4 megabytes.
By default, but I can change it to when I'm creating, I can make it 1 megabyte or 255 most probably, or 6, right? 5 should be 5, right? Then when I I'm going to put this in a volume group, put this in a group. Put these both disks in a group. What is the name of the group? VG01. This is the name of the group. What is the command to put them in a group?
VG, add or
create. Put them first time so we can. So VG?
Create.
VG create and add both disks. You don't have to add one by one, right? If you have 10, you add together, right? So VG create and add all the disks, okay? So I can put VG create. Where's VG create? VG create, VG01, first disk, second disk, third disk, fourth disk, fifth disk. I add all the disks. Okay? Yeah. So I added. So now I have in my VG01, how many disks I have?
Two.
I have two. So now I have two disks. This is the first disk. Now users, look at this as a disk or as a logical device. This is a logical device. When I created, this is a logical device. So people look at this. I don't touch that. If you touch this, if you try to start using this or try to UFS using this, you will destroy your data. So you forget about this. Right? Even if in the file system tab, FS tab, in FS tab, FS tab is like VFS tab in Solaris. In FS tab, we put all the file systems that has to be mounted during the boot up. So in that also use this. Don't use that. Okay? Yeah. Okay, so now this is physical extent. Now this will automatically create what? Logical?
Volumes.
Extent. Volumes you have to create manually. Okay? So here we have some physical extents, here we have some logical extents.
Isn't that like a swap file?
No. sub-disk. This is like sub-disk in Veritas. Okay. Like sub-disks. Okay. So what are those? So if I have 10 here, how many will be created here?
10.
If it is 4 megabyte each, how many megabyte each?
Four.
It will be exactly the same. You can't have different size. That's why you have to decide the size. If you feel that you are going to copy a big chunks of data, like big diagrams, big images, then make it more than 4 meg when you are creating this, okay? By default, 4. So if you create 4 meg physical extent, here also it will be 4 meg logical extent, okay? Will they be mapped to each other?
Mm-hmm.
Exactly?
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Oh, definitely.
Mapped to each other.
Otherwise.
Yeah. So, this will be mapped to each other. So by default, we assume that this is mapped to this. This is mapped to this. This is mapped to this. And so on, right? Okay?
So basically what we are saying is physical extent will be mapped to the logical extent, right?
Yes. Then somebody is here in between, an interpreter like, okay, this is a physical extent, okay, go to that logical extent. So somebody is in between. So that's how this guy can exactly go to that logical extent. No, I told the other way, okay. If somebody is here, I'm accessing some information here, so that information is coming from here or from here?
From here, actually.
From here, from there, here, right? If suppose somebody is accessing this, somebody will access this, so the information has to come from here.
Yeah.
So how does this guy know I have to be mapped with this guy? So somebody is in between. It's like a small driver-like thing or an interpreter-like thing. So you are coming from there, okay, your data is here. So like that, right? Okay? Any problem?
I'm sitting like agent.
Like an agent, okay.
Agent.
This is logical volume.
They don't have agent here. Oh, different kind of agent.
Yeah.
Okay. Now we assume that this is a mirror. Think very carefully, huh? So I'm just directly connecting this now. Everybody know what is a mirror, right? Benny, you know what is mirror? So you know what is mirror? Do you know what is mirror?
Mirror
means
mirroring. Okay. Yeah.
Mirroring.
Okay.
Hard drives copying in both hard drives, right? So if suppose we say this is a mirror volume, this is a volume, and that is a mirror. So I took these two hard drives and created a volume. This is the volume, and that volume is a mirror. Now tell me how they are linked. Tell me. Anybody? How they are linked now.
What is a mirror? There are two squares?
This and this are mirror.
So they can access, if for something gone bad in one, so he can use the other one.
Yeah. One is gone, but at least one other one we have.
Yeah.
Each one is called a sub-mirror, right? So in this example, now the first example is directly connecting like this, right? In this example, how is connecting? How is linking?
It will be linked like first one will be mapped to the first and second.
Okay. So first one will this one will be mapped to this one, okay, then?
And it will be mapped to the down.
And also it will be mapped to this one.
Yeah.
So every logical
No, the down.
It's not correct for me to put it as two devices. That's why the confusion came. So when I create a volume, it's one piece. Okay? Volume is one piece, right? I can't put it as two pieces, right? Yeah. Okay, so what will happen? This will be connecting to this, and then also, this will be connected to this also. So when anybody copy a data, I went to market. That will be copied here, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
And that will be copied here, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's how it works. Okay?
Making two copies.
And when you are reading, where will it read from? This one or this one?
First.
So I'm confused.
Why you are confused?
Okay.
Yeah.
So physical extent is mapped to the logical extent, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in this case, the mapping, I'm kind of lost. Mapping, right?
Because, okay, this is my logical extent.
Because they are for.
Okay, this is my logical extent. So, if I am not mirroring, logical extent, physical extent, one-to-one connection. Agree? Right. But now I have a logical extent which is mapped to two physical extents because it's mirrored.
Okay.
So, when I access this, when I write something, it should be written to both.
But in this situation, we will lose the capacity of the hard drive. Like 1 terabyte, we will get only half terabyte.
Yeah, if the volume is 2 terabyte, you are getting only 1 terabyte.
So one logical extent is part of two PEs, basically, right?
One logical extent is not part of two PEs. One logical extend is connected to 2P.
Yeah, connected to 2P, right?
Cannot connect to copying to 2P.
Copying to
or 2P, accessing 2P.
Yeah, copying to 2P.
So actually, I don't know, like, we were connecting two different disks and then we were making a mirror.